This video is about a location for which I knew nothing was eventually on a Google Maps. I have discovered ability to actually see Old Bohumin. This is right on the border with Poland in the Czech Republic just recently, that you can actually see this even through the computer, and it's okay like this. This is everything I do on the computer. It's anyway, it's registering my internet provider addresses. It's not a bad thing. It's not all that bad about the coronavirus. It's also good. Remember, Wi-Fi, no. Libraries, no. So that means everything I did, and this recording here, this was recorded on September 9, 2020, was done through the SIM cards, which I had to purchase through my passport only. That's how you get to buy a SIM card for the internet in either Poland or Czech Republic, where I did not even use internet. Eventually, I did in a library I was once. I think I did in Ostrava once. Here scene, however, never crossed my mind to eventually, until 2 days ago, 3 days ago, when I did the video about Bohumians. Little did I give a damn about this stuff here. This stuff is really coming handy right now. Okay, this location, was recorded exactly at this location on September the 9th, 2020, when I was in the Czech Republic. Today, for your information, October the 26th, 2020. It's maybe the most powerful yet video in respect to the proofs about MKUltra proofs, because one involves a couple who used to work at this cement production facility since from forever. If not exactly the couple, then definitely a man. Alright, this man, I remember him, worked here already in 95, in 96, 97, and ever since. There was another male too, I remember. In fact, I remember two other people, a male and a female. A female looked like this, and was age approximately, I would say, I estimate about 50, I would say, at the time. Eventually 95, 96, 97, 98, I have seen her. I remember her still sometimes in 2001, something like this. And then it would be a male, another male, not the gentleman you're about to hear me conversing with, but another male. And it's why I have assumed that there was another couple here, especially because he, the gentleman I am going to talk with, explained to me that there are workers here, let's just say maintaining presence at this facility on rotation shifts. Therefore, you would have people that rotate themselves. Yeah. They would come. I zoom myself eventually like this on a satellite and straight into the area. This is where you would have what you have seen, this cement production facility, and right here across too. And at this place here, right across here that you see, they have like, before they didn't have that big. I see now this is also a big container. But before, when we would come here, it wouldn't be that big. I think it was like a half of what you see here of this. I think it was half. It was not in actually, I'm not sure, because I didn't ever manage to see this from up close again. I am very unsure about it. But in 95, 96, this was not in a good state. They always had dogs barking and so on. Always was this thing. And they still have it. It could well, however, be, and this is why this is a super, super powerful stuff, that the redhead lady, who was in 1995, probably at the age I estimate, somewhere between 45 and 50, I estimate. Actually, to be exactly, I would give her age 47 in year 1995. 47 is what I'm gonna give her. 47, 48, 48, 47, 48. That the lady you're seeing here actually was the wife of the gentleman I am talking to. His present wife is stocky and has got dark hair. When compared to a redhead, I have eventually even fallen for. And it appears to me more and more that she, as she suggested also under MK Ultra, have fallen for me. I'm not sure whether if this was his wife was the main reason why he might have got rid of her, because under MK Ultra, they demonstrated her as a Nazi sympathizer, and I'm not sure whether this was because she liked me. Or was it for some other reason? I do not know. Maybe he was his boss. Maybe I should say her boss. Maybe it was another couple after all. He got rid of it. However, this gentleman you're about to hear became very, very political. And he has a tendency to be quite, how can I say, properly in Slovenian, that would be nadut. He's quite, well, to put it briefly, brazen. He's brazen because eventually the gentleman, brazen and confused, I would say. Brazen and confused, probably this would be like the best description of it. I am not insulted though for him being brazen and I'm trying to find the proper word about it. Confused. Brazen because as you're gonna hear him how he talks to me. This gentleman seems like have completely forgotten what he did under MK Ultra. And confused because he actually thinks that the person that is drugged up, you can do anything you want to do to one. Actually, he believes that the torture is the right that he and his pals eventually had. That it was just, I guess, that I'm not a human being in that sense. No, I cannot take these things too damn seriously. I cannot take them to my heart, is what I'm trying to say. And I cannot do that because obviously he did suffer from some sort of mental issues as well. He is just not, I would say, a good-looking, average male, I would say. A man has certain setbacks, disabilities, facial disadvantages too. And I've been very, 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 very unpleasant. I'm not going to even use the word inappropriate because I deem that not calling for help, not allowing me to obtain help was very, very inappropriate. It was the wrong thing. Okay, so when you have this kind of issues, I am not going to go and judge against myself, obviously not. But probably because of the atmosphere itself, because of what Americans brought here, and it was a high degree of racism, division within the society, because of his physical disadvantages, maybe even because of my flirting with, I'm not sure whether this was his wife or not, did he divorce her in 2001, 2002, as he said, that he got rid of her. he was involved in quite a few things. The people here started to do, it was very funny stuff that started to go on. I do not know how far did he go in this, all this thing here. How much he had to do with misfortune of other people. I'd like to believe nothing really. But it was a madness. Okay, the stuff that went on is leaving me confused in all this. It's very confusing from my perspective to eventually even interact with a person like this. Even though that I stated what I did recognize was very unpleasant, not inappropriate whatsoever, but very unpleasant for him when he handled me under that character, at least he thought that he handled me. Very unpleasant. I give him a lot of stuff probably to for him to ponder over time on a lot of issues, which under normal circumstances, of course, I would never even think about doing it. I would never even think about doing it. But boy, when you really don't want to be drugged up and you are tormented with a million and one issue, it just becomes a burden, the whole thing. And oftentimes you're looking for the way out. And the way out, since you cannot run, you cannot escape, you cannot hide yourself, eventually is to make yourself as unpleasant as possibly you can. You cannot physically defend yourself. The police is not going to defend you. Nobody's going to come out and help you, give you a hand. You are really, really left on your own. And so that is why I don't actually really blame, hold myself responsible in any sense. No, I'm not going to even go, like I said, into some kind of whether this is the right thing you're about to hear from his side or not. I'm not going to go into that kind of stuff. What he did undoubtedly is a crime. When person is drugged up, hijacked, tortured, you're conversing with a person, lying to the person, omitting facts. They are so close, they are so personal to this person. It's a crime itself. There's no excuse for one either. But like I said, I'm not here to deepen something between the people, whatever the people might have. This is for the people of this community to tangle, untangle, whichever way they want to pursue these things is. To me, the gentleman, I do not blame one for absolutely anything, because to me is more, I see him more from the side, from the mental side, that he had other issues going on in his head rather than some kind of political, you know, whatever. He just not capable, I guess, to accept the reality as is. Buried resentment inside of him against me for whatever, and I'm not going to go into it, all right? I'm not going to go into it. It doesn't touch me really in any way, all right? So if I can't do him any good, I'm just going to leave this up to him, okay? I'm not going to say that he is a political or something like this. He did got involved in the political stuff, as he boasted also about against other people as well. But from my side, I don't see him enough to the degree like I did the other guy. The guy who would lie about the old lady when I asked him about whether that was his mom or not. He did not get enough attention from me that I would give him an attribute, that I would actually credit him with something that he would be capable to produce something bad to some other person straight through something like that. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe he is bad. It's possible that he is a very bad person. But because of the stuff that I stated, because of the personal issues he had, Because of maybe wife, he might have lost even through this case, and he wouldn't be the only one. It was quite a few people that did so. I'm just gonna set this aside. I'll let him deal with that stuff, okay? Now, what you see here did not look as good as this, but it was close to what you see here, and her haircut was just like that. And I don't even know how you say that in English language. We're just gonna go like this. Yeah, spotted. I guess it's a spotted. She would have like spotted dots, not too many. A pretty woman. That just simply disappeared sometimes in 2001, 2002. For whom I actually believe was his wife. He counters my claim of presence of any kind of couple, of anybody. Nor did anybody else knew for that matter. And I have recordings of other people as well, as I insisted and insisted and insisted that such lady, in fact, existed right here. Okay, right at this spot, that this was exactly where, you know, I would never forget her, you know. A lake, a good-looking lady that expressed interest in me that disappeared. No way. I'm not going to say 99.9% fact what I state. This is just a fact of the matter. This is just completely undeniable fact of the matter that she was here, this property. His wife or not his wife, maybe one of the workers that rotated here, I do not know. The gentleman's obviously that he is angry, the lady even more later on. They would come back again. They told me, she told me, that if I don't pick up myself away from there, the police is going to be called and so on. Not seeking, absolutely avoiding any kind of police attention, any causing any kind of troubles, anything like this. I did so. I did not even attempt to challenge anybody or anything like this. All through, I believe the Czech law is very specific, and in Poland and in Slovenia and Czech Republic, that everybody has the right to access to the lake. Absolutely everybody. Slovenia, actually, even the properties that border the waterfront properties don't have the right to total closure to the beach. Anywhere you can access them. Nobody has the right to fence them. In fact, if it's badly fenced, you have the right to actually even enter through the main entrance and proceed to the water. Such is the law, I believe, also in Czech Republic. People bike here. People come here for fishing all the time. I've not seen anybody swimming this time, but in the past many did. I, however, did not want to argue with it, and so my bathing, my washing clothing ended on this day. This was the last time. Then the only thing I would do is I would concentrate more on Ostrava location. This was recorded on September 9, 2020 in Old Bohumin. That's basically on the Czech side of the border. On Polish-Czech border. Okay, right along this lake here. Now, the gentleman here is not the only one who would lie. He really, really knows me very well. There is, in fact, a lot of stuff they have attempted to do, including with this property here. The stuff that went on here was actually really violent. It was really, really violent, angry stuff that went on. More related to the people from outside that would start to see themselves on the picture. Now, there are people like this, like I said, that did this because of the stuff that went on. Americans did disseminate hatred. They brought division to society, racism. However, there are also people like the other guy I presented the other day, who did this for the political purposes, and that can be actually seen from the attitude. I do not defend Nazis, obviously. I am probably the only individual that openly counters about what went on and is fighting for the rights of the people, for the majority rights, I'm gonna say. And the people that are politically related are the people who continue to defend the politicians. These are the people who continue to hide facts about the politicians, who continue to criminally get involved against me. That means it wasn't for what they claimed to the people back then, the causes, but it's for completely personal agendas they have. Those are the politically motivated into crime people that I go after, that I do not stop. But like I stated, this gentleman is not one of them, despite what you're about to hear. It was really, really unpleasant. Nobody, for that matter, with exception what I deem was one individual, I would classify into this category from entire Old Bohumin, really. People aren't like this. This gentleman just maybe had too much hard time. Maybe it was life too hard. And unfortunately, he took upon himself, to see me in a bad light. Yeah, I cannot even say I'm sorry, because it wouldn't be honest, to be honest. Okay? So I believe this was his wife until 2001, 2002. But he would not even want to hear about anything, anybody on that property. It was no way to even talk to the gentleman. What you see here no longer even looks like this thing here. This cement processing facility here no longer looks like this. All you need to do is watch this.
You see, they even have their fathers. They even build like a little pool, like a
They did. This is a pool, an old pool that, if you would not know, you cannot even see the pool when you see this thing here. You can't see anything. But when I came here in 95, 96, in 95 this was semi-abandoned, but in 96 they at least halfway cleaned one up. And they did this literally for me. I have never seen fishes swimming inside of this cement-built pool, which was used as a decoration right next to the processing facility for visitors, I guess. But it was there, and I know what it served. It was a pool. It was just a beautiful pool, a pond, let's say, cement-built pond.
Little pool decorated with plants and stuff like this. And now this, I don't know what's going on. This is just really a piece of art on the open, and gonna be decimated to nothing. And
Yep.
definitely it's beautiful to preserve this for them. And to them, big ass lake over there, huge.
This is a very, very small but very, very versatile area where Odra meets two beautiful lakes. And you just happen to have, you see these structures. These are actually really big structures, very, very unusual, like a semi, like a desert, or like somewhere, makes you feel like you're in Greece. And beach is like you have dunes, like it makes you feel like you're somewhere on a Baltic Sea, if I repeat, Americans. And then you have a structure like this one here, which is actually quite a fantastic structure, if you ask me. It's quite structured that would be, I think, like you would all of a sudden you would find yourself somewhere like Americans have seen themselves, somewhere in the Midwest, somewhere in mountains where you would have, let's say, people digging for gold or something like this, in some mine and something like mine and something gold miners, or something like this. Right next to the lake, just as Americans, eventually I do figure out, since this facility, this is also what I failed to ask, because I never looked at this thing here. This facility already was closed in 1996, 97, 100%. This thing you see here, this was all gone. It was none of this stuff here. They closed this facility. They were about to take the whole thing down. And then somehow they did not. Eventually, they even expanded this. They modernized the whole thing. You know, in 1995, 1996, this was just a facility with the house that you see here. I hope that you see it. I hope that I did set this. This thing here, and you would have like something that, like a big thing, like some kind of like a toboggan, like something that it would process the sand through. Like an old-fashioned, this cement processing, something in that sense. Nothing that you see here, this big green, whatever this thing's here. This, they reopened one. When did they reopen one? I have no idea. They reopened one late. Maybe it was year, I don't know. Maybe 2002, I have no idea what the year was. So this thing here stayed closed for some time. And Americans told me, I was brainwashed. It was nothing else but lie here. That the building you see here, it's also a possibility that this eventually will happen. It's gonna turn into a restaurant. That they just gonna wait for me to come. So that I'm gonna photo this, this and that. And they really did. Once I got here, they started to take the whole thing down. Not what you see here, the green stuff. No. All this stuff, the green stuff that you see right there already was gone. Who knows when this stuff was gone. It'd make me feel again like in 96, 97, 95, you know what I mean? I did not even notice. I did not even reminded myself that this facility again was open. And then when I saw this thing on the internet, I was like, wow, man, I said this thing was meanwhile again open. You see, this is all the stuff that if I would knew about this stuff, I would definitely go to the locals and I would get, again, green light from the locals about more knowledge. I did unfortunately not check this ability to see stuff like that. All right, so this was taken in 2012, as you see, from Google Maps is indicating. Americans insisted this to be, if it's going to be turned into a restaurant, for the original building eventually to be preserved for the future generations, so that the children would get to see something like this, something so unusual, and it's such an unusual place. They insisted eventually even for something for the children to be built next to this restaurant. It could be a big parking area, a very exclusive place. I myself, however, I figure out that no restaurant, if you ask me, would be worth it to be placed on a place like this. Now, if it would be a restaurant like this, because I deem this to be exclusive area, really. I love nature so much that I would preserve the nature as it is. To me, it's just nature is just completely perfect. Nothing can change the beauty of the nature. And this thing here, this looks like almost like a gold miner place. It's like it kind of a tops with this place. It's super unusual place along the lake, beautiful that you can go swim. Wind blows. I mean, it's just really gorgeous. All right, let's go to the business here and let me take care of this so that I don't completely lose myself. This is the talk we had, September 9, 2020. There was a couple here, am I correct, sir? '96, '97 up to 2000. One lady, one man. No, he's not even answering to me. He's talking about something completely different. He understands me everything. He talks about something different.
Yeah.
Okay, I say, listen, I said, I'm nice, I've been really nice, okay, I said, and I also thank you, yeah, I also apologize, I was here and I'm about to go, that she said, is that your clothing? Because I was drying my clothing here, this place, you know, that's why. I hang the clothing around here, this is finished, this place, there's nobody here, this is abandoned. And he goes on to tell me, pick them up and basically disappear from here. We don't want you basically here. The lady later on comes and starts to even tell me that if I don't pick myself from there, and this completely without any reason, as we already made an agreement that within 1 hour I'll be gone. She's gonna call the police on me and stuff like that. So this was like, whoa, like extremely, extremely aggressive. Yet, you know, I declined to have anything that I would return them anything back whatsoever. Eventually, I asked them, where exactly can I, you know, I wanted to determine what is their property here so I wouldn't violate their property rights, or through this is not even fenced, whatever. And so they tell me that all this is their property technically, and this and that, and tra-la-la. This is not his property. Man is just a worker over there, but you know, peace, brothers. Let's do it again. First he said yes when I said there was a couple here. Then he's like, I don't even understand what he said in Czech language, whatever. And they grab the stuff with this lady and they go. And I said, okay, thank you, all the best to you, bye-bye, basically. Okay, dry this and disappear, so the police won't have to come. I think she said either here or she said this at some other point of this audio recording, as this is not the whole thing, you know. This is the audio recording. It's actually longer than that. They allow me to dry them. He gives me the time. He gives me the time, and I comply. I say, I understand, thank you. And please tell me what else is yours here so that I don't, you know, interfere with your property rights, whatever. I don't want to cause you trouble.
Podsekané, co tu je, to patří kamenolomu. Teoreticky v hráze, jak schází dolů, z toho nasypu,
od tego do,
až v balikaličok na druhé straně.
Do všichni do druhé strany. Čekajte, a vy jste o tom?
My tam máme středisko v Lidaci.
A vy žijete tam, tak?
Ne, my se střídáme.
Ale...
I ask him, and you're from there, right? I am desperately trying to get him to tell me about the stuff I have stated, because to me it doesn't do anything that he actually ignores me. Of course he lives there, but some way, somehow, I have to make him talk. I have to make him talk about this lady, and he knows very well what I am trying to do, and I said, but wait, you're from there, right? You live there. And he says, no, we are rotating there. We don't live there. We rotate there.
Okay. To je jenom středisko takové. Kancela. No.
Aha, rozumím.
Že 12 hodin den a po 12 hodinách to přijde jinší.
Ale u přeslosti tam byli jedný pár tam. Od tam do nějaké do láta 2000.
Okay, he actually tells me one person. Okay, that actually completely explained to me everything. This actually was his ex-wife. If it's one person and he is not with the lady, that means that he also had his old lady with him back then. So that's what this was. And there was another worker then in that case. So this is what this is. So he knows that exactly what I'm talking about, exactly what I'm going to go to and what I'm going to try to do. So there you have it. So this is yet maybe even the most, the craziest, the most powerful proof. So we're going to go about this one here as well. This is beautiful. That's here. That's here. Yes, yes, talk to me. Okay. Haupi, that's basically the Polish side. That's, if I understand properly, this is basically where I came from. So. Okay, so. The two take some stuff, they're gone, that's all there is to it. The only thing I failed to mention here was that I was even told that to make the document, take photos of this place here, that this is not going to be. Under MK Ultra I was told all this stuff. And to send this through the Facebook, so the Americans could see that stuff, which I definitely did once they started to chop the old building this year. It actually squeezed me too when I saw this thing falling apart. When they started, I don't know if even this here is, if it's still there. Because they started to chop this. They started to cut this with a saw. This is all metal, folks. I was told that it's dangerous to keep this around because it's young people that come here to smoke. Drink, and it's therefore just better to take this away. I disagree with it, but yeah, it's their land, and of course a structure like this could be a health hazard liability, and so accordingly they act with this. So I understand, not my call. And they did this just like in 98. Boy, I have seen some couples having sex here in this building, even, to be completely honest with you. Just like in 97, when they emptied this building here, this one here that you see, they left. They did the same thing. They threw everything, all the books, everything, and they left me like a booklet, which can be heard eventually, I think, on an audio recording somewhere at some point in some other audio recording. They left me. I did preserve the impressions about MK Ultra when I would get to those places, so that I would remind myself. So we documented. So if somebody would ask me or whatever, I remember everything. But anyways, I wanted to see what it feels like when you enter into the place like this, full of memories. They would leave me a books and open, you know, inside was the furniture and stuff like this. They told me to take a photos and videos of all this stuff. It didn't make me any sense today when I think about it. It should, because that is actually the proof that they, well, this place here, this Bohumins, Old Bohumins and Novi Bohumins, this is for me really like a home. I would not allow anybody to make me feel uncomfortable. For me, this is just the people here, I love them. If I did hurt somebody, that somebody really suffered, I am sorry. I'm not going to say I'm not sorry. I am sorry that I was a tool like this, the tool of manipulation, But of course, I'm not going to assume any kind of responsibility for this stuff. This is something I cannot do. What I can do is I can help people. I feel sorry for them if they got affected with what went on. But I definitely, absolutely have nothing to do with any of it. Americans destroyed my life. The people whom Donald Trump brought with him, unfortunately, were the kind of people that even divided the United States of America. There is a civil war that goes on over there. And really, there was nothing I possibly could do about it. So, if you want to do something good, if you meant anything about what you stated to me under MK Ultra, I really didn't take anything personal, to be honest, then you should make yourself up under the real circumstances to which you witnessed today. Because just a blah, 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 blah you did under MK Ultra, that is not worth anything. That does not count. That tells me and that tells the world this is crickets. It's nothing. The worst you do is by basically acting like this arrogantly. Arrogance is the proper term. And just really stupid, ignorant, basically. Rather than to cooperate and at least, I'm going to say, act like a normal person should. All right? Because there's nothing normal about acting like this. Unless somebody told you to act like an idiot, I'm going to say. All right, if somebody told you, if the politician ordered you to act like this, but that's just not the case because most of the people, 90% of the people I came across were actually really nice, and that included the people that, well, it was all kinds of stuff that went on. And it was the people that I did bad stuff to them, and it was the people that hurried me to meet me, to greet me, they came my way, in my direction to help me out. And I know they were badly affected. I have met people who suffered tremendously because of the stupidities, because of my stupidities I did. And I know they got affected badly. Yet they declined to have anything to do with some kind of other issues, with some kind of stuff that some people try to cover up for, even for the cost of the people alone whom they have lied, mislead about other people so they could cause them harm and so on. So it was all kinds of stuff. I don't have anything else I would add to this video here. This is just audio. Don't think I swallowed this even for a second.
Not so good
okay. It hurts me a little bit when you get like this kind of stuff like this, but what can you do? You know, people react differently. This is just, unfortunately, this was the cause. Nor did his new wife, I believe, that became in 2003, probably 2004. I have no idea when he got involved with her.
Well, when
like me, and nor did he.
I can remember the lady. Was a really good looking lady in her 50s.
Mm-hmm. I estimate it was about 53, 52, something like this,
it
when
probably not so good looking.
In 2001, she something like this.
There. And so on and so forth.
Just a moment. Okay, it doesn't matter. This is what I'm trying to get. I'm trying to get about this lady. Now, this is what I was trying to get. This is what I was after, you know. That's all for this video. This is a super mega powerful proof. Nobody knew anything about this lady. Okay, so I do. I remember this. I gave a good description of her age, color of the hair, and it doesn't get any better than that. Eventually, I'm going to tell you, there was a little bit, maybe even some kind of blondish hair. But the hair was like this, messed up like this. Maybe, yeah, even more messed up like this. That's all I can tell you for this video. Thanks for watching. Again, this was recorded on September the 9th, 2020, and today just happened to be October the 26th, 2020.